died.
We need your help.
Please hear us out before you reopen our schools. Border border accidents kill us, but so do teenage pregnancies.
We are suffering with studying at home, but we are also suffering with STIs.
We thank you for access to college education.
But we also need access to sexual and reproductive health information that is appropriate for different ages.
Oh, and speaking of schools, mathematics and English
are great, but we need to have a safe and healthy learning environment.
Please pass the National School Health Policy.
Please pass the National School Health Policy.
Please pass the National School Health Policy before schools reopen.
And save our lives.
This message is brought to you by Voices for Health.
We need your help.
Please hear us out before you reopen our schools. Border border accidents kill us, but so do teenage pregnancies.
We are suffering with studying at home, but we are also suffering with STIs.
We thank you for access to college education.
But we also need access to sexual and reproductive health information that is appropriate for different ages.
Oh, and speaking of schools, mathematics and English
are great, but we need to have a safe and healthy learning environment.
Please pass the National School Health Policy.
Please pass the National School Health Policy.
Please pass the National School Health Policy before schools reopen.
And save our lives.
This message is brought to you by Voices for Health.
Yes, indeed. Voices for Health. We have been focusing on a lot, especially COVID-19, and here we are. We have our students, we have our children, we have our babies out there. We're not paying attention to what's going on to them, yes? So Voices for Health is here, and they're worried that the National School Health Policy has not been passed. And what is taking that long? Why are we not passing that policy? Why don't we even have it in the first place? Yes, so they're here with me. And we're going to look at what exactly this means, how that can be worked around. But we have been seeing reports. One of them, a student aborted and died at a man's home. A student during the lockdown. We've seen cases about very many cases of forced marriages. We've seen cases of unwanted pregnancies with our children. And we've seen cases of our children having STIs, having all sorts of diseases, and we have no policy dealing with them. We have no policy looking out for them. Who should be held accountable is a question you should answer or ask yourself. But I have with me ladies here who are going to help me answer that question and very many other questions. Now, joining us this morning is Dr. Dina Nachiganda, the Assistant Commissioner, Adolescent and School Health at the Ministry of Health. Also, we have with us a young leader, a voice of the youth. She is called Patricia Catherine Najita, the Voices for Health young leader. They're joining us on set this morning. Ladies, welcome to the show and a very good morning.
Good morning, thank you.
Wonderful, wonderful. So what is this? Yesterday, this has been trending, by the way. Hashtag NSHP now has been trending since yesterday. What is this policy? What is it about? Why should we be concerned? Why now? I'll start with you.
Okay. Good morning, our viewers, and thank you. The National School Health Policy is a set of procedures and strategies, and it really spells out how schools and the environment around should ensure that we prevent but also promote the good health of the students, and we also ensure that their development in regards to education is perfect. And health means not only being healthy, you're well, but it means you're mentally well, uh-huh. You're physically well, your nutrition is good to go, and you know, the whole body as it is. And of course your sexuality too, but also ensuring that the children do their education well. So it's a complex of health and also education development for the children, the students, but also their teachers,
okay,
and also the extended community in which they stay.
That's right. Mm. Now, we have seen that COVID-19 pandemic has exacerbated, of course, pre-existing sexual abuses and exploitation of girls. There are also various reports of increased forced marriages, teenage pregnancies. My question is, what does passing of this policy mean?
Okay, like we've said, what the policy is, it's a set of planned strategies.
Yes.
So once we have this going on through, that means we have a standard in all our schools. As we speak now, we know that we have public and private schools.
Mm-hmm.
We have schools that are religiously aligned religiously and those that are not. So somehow we all kind of tend to follow our different realities and beliefs. But if we have a national school health policy, that means that there would be a standard on how children are dealt with at school in regards to, for example, now this pandemic that
mm-hmm.
we have.
Mm-hmm.
There would be a standard to show that if such happens in a school, these are the stepwise processes that we would do in such a pandemic, for example.
Okay.
In regard to nutrition, we would have things like a standardized school menu, and that means a child in a UPE school, Very Fine My Village, would kind of have a basic standard of a menu at school. That means you wouldn't be seeing children sleeping around at lunchtime without lunch, while others are enjoying a very comprehensive lunch somewhere else.
Mm.
So this kind of standard means that every child in this country would have a basic minimum of how they can attend their basic education. That means we'd have programs like health education and physical education. We know that we don't have a standard program for this in most schools. I want to give an example. I've been around many schools and children don't even know that they're supposed to have a parade on which they'll check their hair, check their nails, check to see that their temperatures are not high. That means children just get into the school and, okay, there they go, and they get into a class. We know for sure that there are some schools that don't even have a little space for the children to play around during the breaks. And with this kind of complex, that means the children in the country cannot be at an even point. That means they will not progress evenly. And that means the quality of the Ugandan that we'll have so many years later will not be standardized. You find a university student and they can't speak at the same level because of the kind of upbringing that they got through, no standards or whatsoever. And this, of course, damages what we eventually have in the future. And that means the skill set, in the end, is not the standard skill set that we should have. It's not the perfect skill set that we should have for a country. And that means economically, the country is also put at stake.
Mm. Right. Ladies, you notice that this policy has been around for 19 years and has not been passed. It is actually eligible for voting next year, if it were a person. What has taken it this long? And who is responsible? 19 years is such a long time.
I think I'm still smiling because of the voting bit.
Yes, it is. It is really eligible.
Well, it sounds funny, but again, a bit distressing on
Absolutely.
The other hand, because
yes.
that means it's been on the shelves for quite long.
Yeah.
But just to say that, as we've explained, school and then at school and then health, so there's been that complexity of who actually owns this policy. Is it in the Ministry of Health or is it in the Ministry of Education? And this is something that the discussion has gone on for almost that time, because ownership is really, really important. And you know what ownership comes with? It comes with who implements it, who actually has the mandate to make sure everything goes well around it. But that said, once that was cleared at one time, then other processes came up again. For example, previously, things like a regulatory impact assessment were not very key in passing policies, but now the cabinet came up with that kind of requirement that for any policy to pass, there has to be a regulatory impact assessment. And this is a process that takes stakeholder engagement, stakeholder consultations. And you know, for things where many stakeholders are involved, it would take as long. So that process also took some bit of time. And with this, there comes issues of costing, you know, which probably were not done. And of course, when all this was set, again, the pandemic came in and it just slowed everything down. But we hope and know that it will be out very soon now.
We are hoping and looking forward.
Yeah.
Now, to you, Patricia, reports have indicated just about a few weeks ago that some 2,300 school-going children, girls especially, had been impregnated and 128 married off during the lockdown. As a Voices of Health leader, what does this imply, and what are we doing wrong, or what are we not doing at all?
Not doing right.
Yes.
Good morning, our viewers. Really happy to be here and to share with everyone. I'll start answering this by going back to you. A question you just asked, why has it taken so long for the National School Health Policy to pass? An aspect, it's a comprehensive thing, it's big, but an aspect of it is the sexual reproductive health aspect. Mm-hmm. And this is the aspect of it that would educate our young boys and girls on how to prevent what you're mentioning is happening to them, the teenage pregnancies and the everything. But as we are sharing, there are very many people involved in this religiously, in the ministry and everything, and dealing with things sexual is not exactly an easy thing for people to take on. Because we've seen mothers and fathers that fail to talk to their children about things concerning sexual education. That's it's not an easy thing to do. Yeah, so given that the National School Health Policy is passed, there would be an aspect in that that would take care of providing the good information to our young boys and girls on how to protect themselves against such things.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Actually, talking about these things is taboo in all homes.
Yeah.
We'll take a break. When we return, we continue looking at exactly why this policy needs to be passed, what has been happening, and what do teachers have to say about this.
Next time.